is a story that came out on CNBC, Painkiller, America's Opioid Plague Uncovered. And this story came out May 31st, 2018. We're going to go ahead and listen to the video.
Purdue Pharma knew its opioids were being widely abused early on, but still marketed them as less addictive and may have helped lead to the epidemic that we have today. Joining us right now, Barry Meyer. He's a Pulitzer Prize winning journalist, New York Times reporter, author of Painkiller, An Empire of Deceit and the Origin of America's Opioid Epidemic. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you, Andrew.
So this is the new information here is that the Justice Department, right?
Correct.
Had gone to Purdue and said, there's a problem here very early on.
In fact, the new information is that the Justice Department had found a wealth of evidence showing that Purdue knew that these drugs were being abused, that knew they were people were getting addicted to them, and that effectively the company covered it up. This was in the late 1990s. This was just in the few years after OxyContin's introduction.
Not only covered it up, but continued to market this drug, saying that it was less addictive than other drugs like Vicodin or
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty incredible. I think the book tells the story of what may be the biggest corporate cover-up of our time. I know you guys have reported a lot about financial frauds and people getting ripped off, but here we have a situation of a huge public health crisis being created.
So the question is, do you think that we can say that what happened then has led to where we are today? Because the company will say, look, we make OxyContin, but there's lots of other opioids out there now. We're just a small part of the business, if you will. Right.
They were a $31 billion part of the business. The whole opioid era was launched by the aggressive and illegal marketing of OxyContin. There had been no drug prior to OxyContin that had been marketed as widely and broadly as Purdue Pharma marketed this drug.
What has Purdue Pharma's response been to your book, to this information that came from the Justice
Department? Pay no attention. We're just a little part of the problem. There are a lot of other factors here. And the drug problem today is multifold. It's two-pronged.
How many deaths per year are there, and how many would you say are linked to OxyContin?
You know, there are about 60,000 overdose deaths a year. I don't know how many today are linked to OxyContin, but certainly a decade ago, there were a large number of deaths and overdoses and hospitalizations that involved OxyContin.
Just a small number of the deaths.
So react to this. By the way, the CDC says that over the past two decades, more than 200,000 people have died directly from OxyContin itself, not just opioids broadly. This is what Purdue does say. They say, suggesting that activities that last occurred more than 16 years ago are responsible for today's complex and multifaceted opioid crisis is deeply flawed.
Correct. But the fact of the matter is that Purdue marketed this drug in an aggressive and illegal manner.
Okay, so the next question is, what should happen to Purdue? And by the way, where was the Justice Department throughout all of this?
Let me start with that second part first. The Justice Department had an opportunity to prosecute the executives of Purdue. That was the recommendations of the prosecutors on the case. They wanted these individuals to be charged with serious crimes. But top Justice Department officials in the Bush administration essentially blocked that. And I think one of the themes I try to present in the book is that had those prosecutions gone forward, there would have been a message sent out to other drug company executives that this behavior was unacceptable and that there was a serious price to be paid.
Why did they choose not to?
You know, I guess they were afraid. They buckled when, you know, confronted by Purdue's, you know, high-powered legal defense team. I mean, Rudy Giuliani was one of their advisors at the time. You know, that's something they have to answer to. But certainly the prosecutors on the case recommended that there be very serious felonies be brought against the executives.
If you just took it in pill form, was it a better way of treating of pain management? And then did people figure out what do you do, inject it or snort it?
Well, people figured out they could crush it and snort it very quickly.
Purdue knew they could.
Yes,
was the pill itself a better way to manage pain?
You know, it was being promoted that way, but basically, it was just a long-lasting form of Vicodin or Percocet.
Okay, and then quickly, people found out you could crush it and snort it.
Exactly.
Did other manufacturers ever get notice from the Justice Department or anybody else about the same kind of claims that had been made to Purdue?
You know, the Justice Department has not gone after these companies sort of with any great vigor. And, you know, part of the tragedy here is that when they didn't go after Purdue, it was kind of a green light for everybody else to kind of go wild.
Right. Where do you think we are in terms of the administration has talked a lot about the opioid crisis and what it wants to do? What is the state of play?
You know, I think it's very important. I mean, you have an audience of business people and executives who can play a tremendous role in helping to staunch this epidemic by making sure that people who are in pain are treated with, you know, the best possible treatments for pain, not simply pain pills. You know, they can make sure that the companies that provide insurance to their employees give them far better pain treatments.
Barry Meyer, the book is Painkiller. It is eye-opening, and go take a look at it. Appreciate it.
Now,
it's a breaking news.
You have to be a fool not to believe that these pharmaceutical companies knew how addictive those drugs were, opioids. I mean, it's opium. This country already went through 100 years ago an opioid epidemic. And actually, you went through it several times. This is not the first time. This is the longest lasting one, for sure. But it's not the first one. How do you not know that opium is not addictive? They knew. And it just go to show you, ladies and gentlemen, every damn thing in this country is about money. They will sell their own people out for money. And that's exactly what they did. And this is why you're looking at an epidemic today. They didn't care. They were making money. And they wanted that money to continue to come in. That's what Purdue Pharma did. They could care less about what effect it had on people. They became billionaires off of that drug. You think they're going to stop putting it out? Although they know there were multiple problems and people were even showing signs of addiction even back in the 90s. And they continued to market it, just like they said. This addiction is never going to go away. Ladies and gentlemen, it is too many people that are getting paid at the expense of these addicts, and they're not going to cut that money off and end up with nothing. So they will let these people just fall out here on the drugs. They don't care. Please tell me what you think. Please leave your comment and subscribe. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell, and I will see you on the next video. Peace, family.